Hello, and thanks for joining me for the Bismarck Weather Education Center's video on the El Nino Southern Oscillation. Many of you have probably heard about El Nino and even La Nina, but did you know they are simply parts of the El Nino Southern Oscillation, or ENSO? If you like, you can read an official definition of ENSO, but most importantly, remember three key things. ENSO is a relationship between the ocean and the atmosphere. It occurs because of periodic warming or cooling of sea surface temperatures, and it happens over the equatorial Pacific. Let's start with the where. The equatorial Pacific refers to the region of the Pacific between South America, Papua New Guinea, and Australia. Now let's take a closer look at this region under normal or neutral conditions. Strong easterly trade winds blow warm surface water west towards Australia. This allows cold water to upwell along the coast of South America. This is where the ocean begins to interact with the atmosphere. Colder water results in relatively high pressure, and the warmer water results in relatively low pressure. Just like anywhere, with low pressure and ample warm, moist air, there is rising air and thunderstorms. A lot of thunderstorms, in fact. So much that the rising air contributes a great deal to the upper-level jet stream flowing back toward South America, that then cools, descends, and starts the circulation all over again. Now for the warm phase of ENSO, or El Nino. Weaker easterly trade winds cause less upwelling along the South American coast, allowing for warmer water to expand further east towards South and Central America. The area of low pressure expands with the warmer water, and the area of high pressure shrinks. Thunderstorm activity expands with the warmer water to the east, which then leads to a shifted upper-level jet stream. The cold phase of ENSO, or La Nina, is the complete opposite. Easterly trade winds are much stronger, which confines warm surface water further west and allows for greater expansion of upwelling off the coast of South America. Centers of relatively high and low pressure are shifted further west as well, along with thunderstorm activity being confined further west near Papua New Guinea, once again leading to a shifted upper-level jet stream. So now maybe you are thinking, what does all this about the jet stream and sea surface temperatures in the Pacific have to do with weather conditions here in North America? Well, think of the old adage about when a butterfly flaps its wings halfway around the globe, we feel the effects here. Well, think of ENSO as a much, much larger butterfly flapping its wings. When the jet stream over such a large area, like the equatorial Pacific, shifts, the effects of that shift are felt globally. In some places, the change to weather is negligible, shown in gray, but in others, the change can be drastic, shown by the highlighted areas. For instance, the southeastern U.S. can expect a wetter and colder than normal winter during El Nino. Thanks for joining me, and I hope this video helped you understand the El Nino Southern Oscillation a little better. For more on the subject, check out the Climate Prediction Center's website. And for more on what El Nino and La Nina mean for North Dakota, stay tuned to our homepage, Facebook page, and Twitter feed.